Hello. In the previous video, we looked at what types of C# projects are: console applications and class libraries. And I mentioned that the postprocessor is a class library. Let's now just look at what a postprocessor is. I have some open projects that contain some toolpath. It machines this part. The toolpath consists of some commands. Commands, tool loading, spindle, and tool movements, feed rates, coolants, and so on. Now let's start CLD viewer from the menu. And here we have special menu item create a new postprocessor. It creates some new postprocessor from a template. This template already contains some implementation, minimal implementation, to exclude creation of new project from command line, as we did it inside previous video. Let's create new folder. Simple postprocessor. Oh, sorry, not here. Here, simple postprocessor. Now we can open this project inside Visual Studio Code. As I already said, the toolpath contains some commands. And this template already contains some implementation, minimal implementation. But for understanding, I remove all this implementation and we will start creating the postprocessor from scratch. Let's remove. I think I can remove full implementation. So, and let me also delete the registers file. Let's leave its consideration outside the scope of this video. To simplification. Let's look at the postprocessor's C# file. It's very similar to a class library project that we did before in the previous video. It's just .NET project for the Windows platform. Additionally, it contains some settings XML file and it has references to some additional class libraries. These class libraries just implement some useful functions that will help us to implement postprocessors. Just some useful functions. This library contains some common definitions, common types and classes. And if I said something about settings, let's look at the file. It's just some descriptional information about the post-processor. For example, we can type here some information, simple post-processor that has no any CNC system and machine. And it has some additional user-defined parameters. We can remove it, stop it, say that some error. I removed now. Now we can build the post-processor, and this information will appear inside serial data view on the post-processor information section inspector. And I can add additional parameters to the user-defined section, and it will appear here also. But I think we will consider this inside separate video. Now let's look at the code of the post-processor. Here we have some empty post-processor class. Now we must implement some kind of reaction to the serial data commands that come to us. For example, tool movements. In the previous video we did some output to console. Now we can repeat it and output to console information about the command. Let's type override on go to. It's a tool movements and helper makes for us full specification for this command handler. As an input we have serial data command. We can go to definition of this command and we will see that it has endpoint X, Y and Z. Let's output, for example, the name of this command to console. Right line cmd.caption. Let's look to the results. Now we have go to command and the handler is here. Let's look to the terminal and the console has caption of our command. Fully the same as inside serial data view. Now let's look at how our post-processor starts. In the previous video I said that class library has not independent launch system. It can be launched itself. To start class library, we need some program. Let's look at configuration launch JSON file. Here we have the command that VS Code starts. Actually, inside Sprutcam installation folder, there are some inpcore.exe utility. This is some C# console application. It can read Sprutcam projects. It opens Sprutcam projects and start analyzing its CL data. It reads CL data commands and receives this information to the post-processor that it loads as a class library. To know what post-processor to start, it received the name of the post-processor as an input argument. Here we see that it has post-processor file name, but for convenient using, it refers to the environment variable that equals to the current folder name with full path. So this utility launch the post-processor, and from the CL data viewer it knows what the project to open. This is just some additional information to receive messages with CL data viewer. Not so important for us. And the name of the post-processor to load as a class library. Here's also the name simple post DLL. This utility starts loads post-processor and sends commands. And we add some reaction and output this information to console. For example, the name of command. Now let's add some additional handler. For example, to add new handler, we need to write override on, and helper will show all handlers we have. To explore what handlers there are, we can click to the post-processor class, and inside additional file we will see full set of available handlers, for example coolant, movements, circle, feed rates, and so on. Now let's implement, for example, comment to start. We can press Ctrl plus space. It will show helper. All handler starts with on prefix. And implementation follows the same. Now let's check the results. Now console output already have two comments and each write line adds new line to console. For the demonstration, we have more simple way to implement this behavior for all comments at once. The post-processor has special handler that executes before each comment on before comment handle. And if we will write console write line CMD caption here, I think we will see the full set of comments. Let's check. Yes, inside terminal we have the list of comments follow the same as inside CL data viewer. Okay, just simple implementation. Fifteen lines, and we have full set of comments. Very simple post-processor. Now let's consider more real case. Let's go back to the tool movement handler on GoTo. And let's output G-code for the tool movement, override on go to. And for the tool movement, usually we have G0 or G1 with coordinates. For simplification, now we just use G1. G1, and let's explore what we have inside CL data command go to. Let's click with control. And new file appears, but this is special file. It's temporary file, not real file. is created automatically from metadata of the SC post-processor DLL. It's inherited from movement command. Let's go to the command. It has endpoint X, Y, and Z. And we can use X plus Y and plus Z. Now let's check. Yes, inside console we have G and coordinates of the movements. Don't see on the format. For simplification, we just use default converter to string from numbers. Not so useful, but very simple. Now let's consider some additional, for example, circle. Circle is G2 or G3 code. To know what code we need, we can explore parameters of the circle command, and inside description we have some direction flag. It's what we need. It contains two if the movement is clockwise and three if the movement is counterclockwise. And additionally, we need the radius of the circle. Let's type R plus CMD dot R. And now we see that we have several radius. Let's consider description. This radius is negative for direction. Not what we need. The second is always positive, and third is positive when the arc less than half of the circle. Yes, I think we need this value. Inside in the format of ISO G code. Let's check. And now we can see G3 R 39. Parameters are fully the same as inside CL data viewer. Now let's continue. Now we are printing all the information to the console, but it is not similar to the real postprocessor. Actually, postprocessor must output information to the output file. So we need to add, instead of console, some file output. Let's do it. Let's define some in C variable of text and C file type. Text and C file in C. It's just variable declaration, but we need to create this file. To do this, we need to add some additional handler that will be executed first. The first handler is on start project. And inside first handler, we can create new file. C, new text and C file. And the postprocessor is owner of this file. This is the postprocessor. And just replace console to NC variable. Let's check start. Oh, inside your data viewer, the process already finished. Let's create breakpoints. This way we could see it step by step. And repeat again. And one more breakpoint at the start project to be possible to see that we have new file after this execution. Oh, but because we already have one execution, we already have new tab. I want to see how this tab will appear, but another time. Now, when we execute in C write line, this line will appear inside your data view. Let's change breakpoints and continue execution. We will see that each line has its own implementation inside your data viewer. Let's finish. We have some error message because we are creating the new NC file, but we doesn't define the file name. Where to place our file? For example, we need to place it inside our testing folder. See output file name, text, gcode text. Okay, let's repeat. C sharp and backslash is a special symbol we need to add doc char for the constant. Let's check again. And now when we execute a new file, the name of the file will appear inside CL Data Viewer. And as a result, we have the new output file. We can open it inside Windows Explorer. Yes, we have some text file. We can open it with Visual Studio Code. So we are created new simple post processor that makes this output file. I think that's enough for the start. Thanks for watching.